You two seem a bit chummy tonight.
Yeah, well, Leela seems to have had a change of heart where I'm concerned. In fact, she went out of her way to be pleasant tonight.
Another drink?
Yeah, why not? Look, don't worry about another drink. I've had enough of this place. I just want to go to the gents and then we can leave.
Not leaving already.
It's getting lost.
It's not because of me, is it?
I've got to let them know I've lost that pen.
And how can you do that?
If I'm going to put me back in the laundry in the morning, if I can just get out and sneak down until... That's it! That's a signal!
Yeah, you're right. Two quick flashes, like you said.
Oh. They can't come tomorrow.
Everything's going wrong. If I don't get that stuff in the urn tomorrow, I'll never get out of this place.
Oh, all you care about is escaping. You couldn't give a damn about anyone else.
Nothing's going to happen to anyone.
I thought you were smart, Ros, but I was wrong. You're just stupid.
What are you carrying on about?
Look, if those terrorists break in tomorrow and the screws aren't knocked out by drugs, what do you think will happen? You reckon they're going to give it up? Of course not. They won't stop at nothing, even you know that. They'll just mow down everyone in their sight. They won't care who are screws and who are prisoners. They'll just kill a whole bloody lot of us.
It was only a small dent, but the cheapest quote I got was $70. Uh-oh, the Wanderers have returned.
G'day, we're back.
So I see.
Sorry we're a bit late, Leela. Actually, you see, on the way home, we ran into this dear little old lady in the street selling flowers. So I gave her a buck for these.
For me? How very kind of you.
Not at all. Mum has to make a living somehow.
Yeah, sorry, love, I would have got you some too, only, well, the gardener caught me.
With your choice of flowers, I would have got dandelions. Come on, come and help me serve dinner.
Oh, I'll help.
No, 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 you stay here with Jeff and keep him out of trouble.
How's the world of insurance brokers?
Well, never better. I made another $1 million sale this afternoon.
How much did you have at the pub tonight?
Oh, not much. Why?
Well, it's Jeff. He seems, well, not drunk exactly.
Ah, no, it'd take more than a few beers to get Jeff drunk. He's probably just pleased to see Meg. A natural high. Go on, go and serve dinner. I'll get changed.
Kathy, you asleep?
What do you want?
Got a cigarette?
Yeah, on the locker.
You don't smoke.
I need one.
Yeah, well, get me one too.
Can't sleep, huh? Are you sure you didn't tell anyone there were drugs in that pen?
Oh, of course not. What do you think I am, stupid?
I don't know what I'll do if I can't find it.
There's only one thing you can do, Ros, and that's tell the screws.
What?
Look, sometimes lagging's the only thing to do. So what if Janet gets in strife? She's not one of us.
She's my ticket out of here.
Yeah, says you.
She trusted me, and I let her down. I'm not going to lag on her.
Listen, Ros, you don't know what you're getting yourself into. Them terrorists are bloody nutcases. If they come in here and find the screws aren't drugged, they'll just slaughter them.
So what? They're only screws.
So what if they kill Mrs. Jackson? Or Mrs. Powell? And like I said, what about the rest of us? Won't have any hope if they start shooting in here. And you reckon they're going to hang around and wait for you? Especially when they don't have the run of the place.
I'm going to turn this place upside down tomorrow. I've got to get that pen back.
Another port, Jeff.
Not for me, thanks, mate. No, I think I'll be driving Meg home fairly soon.
Meg?
No, thanks, Jim. Excuse me. I've had a very long day.
Well, that's a cue for a chauffeur if ever I've heard one.
Can I give you a hand with the dishes, Leela?
No, don't you dare. You're a guest. I'll do it.
I thought the army taught you not to volunteer for anything.
That always was one of Jim's weaknesses.
Well, thank you for a delicious meal and a lovely evening.
Oh, I'm glad you enjoyed it. I don't often get the chance to show off.
I'm sorry just to eat and run.
Oh, well, the meal would have been a bit earlier except for a few late arrivals.
Look, we must do this at my place sometime.
Yeah, I'd love to.
Love to, yes.
Your carriage awaits.
Oh, good night, Leela. Thanks, Jim.
See you later.
See you tomorrow, Meg.
Did you really only have a couple of drinks this evening at the pub?
You're not still going on about that, are you? What's the big deal?
Jeff. Well, if he wasn't boozed, I've only ever seen him like that once before.
When was that?
In Sydney after the fight.
You never give up, do you? That was years ago, Leela. But you never forget, do you?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean anything by it. Well, it unnerved me. You've seen that sort of thing before. I hadn't.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Friends?
Friends. On one condition. You stop this continual sniping at Jeff. Well, he won't be here for that much longer. And he has been a good mate.
Okay. You win.
Come on in.
Thanks.
Coffee?
No, thanks. I won't stay. You do have a reputation to keep.
I don't care what the neighbours think.
Oh, I didn't
Listen,
mean it.
If I enjoy your company, which I do, then that's good enough for me.
Fair enough. That was a really enjoyable evening, eh?
Yes, much better than sitting alone watching TV.
You don't get up much?
Oh, hardly ever. I find the prison takes a lot out of you. Watching TV is about all I have the energy for most nights. I suppose you're always out and about.
Oh, well, dinner, shows, the movies occasionally.
What sort of shows do you like?
Well, live shows mainly. Don't go in for plays much. Like cabaret, you know, whatever takes my fancy at the time.
I'd love to see that Cossack show. They really fascinate me, all that leaping and kicking.
Oh, the Russian show. Yeah, that's on tomorrow night, isn't it? Well, why don't I take you?
Well, you'd never get a ticket. They're always sold out.
If I can get the tickets, will you come?
Yes, but as I said...
Look, no buts, no buts, no buts. That's all settled. I'll pick you up at 7:30 tomorrow night.
Okay, wise guy. Right, well, I'm about to make a coffee. Would you like one?
It'll keep you awake.
Any objections?
Colson, Leach, get a move on if you want a shower. What's up, Birdsworth? Are you waiting for breakfast in bed?
Oh, me heart.
I'll put on another record, Lizzie. We're sick of that same old tune.
She doesn't look too crash hot to me, Miss Bennett.
I didn't know you were a qualified nurse, Leach.
Oh, the pain in the middle of the night.
Leach, keep an eye on her while I go and call Dr. Miller. You better not be putting this on, Birdsworth. Dr. Miller wouldn't appreciate a false alarm at this time of the morning. Come on, Coulson.
Are you all right, Lizzie?
Oh!
Where are the boys?
Outside playing.
I hope they don't get too dirty. They have to go to school soon. Jim, what pub did you go to last night?
You're not still going on about that, are you?
No, really, which one?
The Blaxland, why?
There was a man found beaten up there last night. Well?
Well, what?
Oh, nothing, forget it.
What's it say?
Karate killer strikes. A man was admitted to hospital late last night with extensive injuries after being found unconscious in the men's room of the Blaxland Hotel. The man, whose name was not released, was unable to give police an accurate description of his assailant. A police spokesman said the injuries were consistent with the type of blows favoured by experts in the martial arts.
Have to change our pub.
Jeff's a black belt, isn't he?
So what? So are thousands of guys in the city. Karate's about as popular as disco dancing these days. Don't jump to conclusions.
I wasn't jumping anywhere. Just got a feeling, that's all. I think you should talk to him about it.
Morning, all.
I'll get some more coffee.
Morning, Leela.
Morning.
What's wrong with her?
No, she's always like that first thing in the morning.
Good night last night, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, apparently we missed a bit of excitement in the pub last night, though.
Is that right?
Yeah, a bloke was found beaten up in the dunny.
Yeah. Another poof to bites the dust, eh?
Why do you say that?
What?
Well, what makes you think that he was queer?
Well, it stands to reason, doesn't it? I mean, he was found in a dunny. If you're going to pick a blue with a bloke in a pub, you don't invite him out to the loo, do you?
No, I suppose not.
I ran into that bloke I was telling you about. A bloke who's talking about going to Africa. Sounds like a great deal.
So you have to become a soldier of fortune now, eh?
Fortune's right, mate. A month's salary every week. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
So's dying.
It's never worried you before.
He's not in the army now.
No. No, I suppose the women's prison system is a far cry from the army. Still, it's not all finalised yet.
Well, Dr. Miller, is she lying or not?
It's hard to say. When did you say this attack occurred, Lizzie?
About 1 o'clock in the morning. Oh, I was real crook, just like the last time. Lucky I was awake. Otherwise, I reckon I'd have snuffed it.
You were awake when it came on?
Yeah. I've been real insomniacal lately. Luckily, I managed to stagger over to me locker and get one of me tablets. It was like a knife stuck in me ventricle. Your ventricle's part of your heart, you know.
I know.
Well, it was a good thing you could get to your medication in time. Can't have been a particularly severe arrest.
I thought so.
Oh, that doesn't mean to say it wasn't potentially dangerous.
I'm living on borrowed time, aren't I, Doc?
Oh, I wouldn't go so far as to say that, Lizzie. You take it easy and you'll be around for a while yet.
You know what struck me, Doc? That real helpless feeling. Supposing I hadn't been able to get one of me tablets. I got no one in the cell with me.
No, that's true.
What I was thinking, if I could move in to another cell, say with Roz or Kath, they could give me a hand if I had a turn in the middle of the night.
I knew this was leading somewhere. It's all a plot to get transferred from her cell.
Oh, fair go, Miss Bennett. I'm living on borrowed time.
You may very well be right, but she does have a point. I'll talk to Mrs. Davidson about it, Lizzie.
Oh, you're a real bottler, Doc.
Now, take it easy or you'll have another attack. I'll give you these tablets to keep with you. I think you're probably well enough to return to normal duties, but if you like, you can rest up here until I see Mrs. Davidson.
Thank you, Doc.
Wipe that stupid grin off your face, Birdsworth.
Oh, well, another day, another dollar, eh? You need a lift to work, Jim?
Will you be wanting the car again? Yes, thanks, mate, I will.
Take your time, mate. I've got to get my briefcase.
All right.
Well, how did he know the man was gay?
Don't be ridiculous, Leela. Jeff doesn't know anything about it.
Why don't you let the police decide that?
It could have been anybody. It could have been me.
Oh, well, you're not like that.
Well, why not? I've learned unarmed combat too, you know.
I'm sure it's not the first time Jeff's done something like this.
Look, I told you last night to lay off about Jeff. I'm going to work. At least I've got some authority there.
You right, Jim?
Yes, thanks, mate.
Hello? Oh, hi.
Oh, hi, Meg. I'm sorry to worry you so early. I won't keep you. I just wanted to ask you about Jeff. Did he seem a little strange last night?
Strange? What do you mean?
Well, sort of exhilarated. Did he mention anything about the pub that he and Jim went to?
No, he was the perfect gentleman. Why?
Oh, nothing. It's just... Be careful of him, Meg.
Listen, Leela, if you've got something to say, then say it.
Well, not long after Jim and I were married, Jim and Jeff were on leave in Sydney, and we went to this RSL club one night, and Jeff got involved in this fight. Oh, I don't know how it started. Anyway, he went berserk. He nearly killed this man. Jim tried to stop him, and he attacked Jim. Anyway, the police arrived and broke it up, and afterwards, Jeff seemed strange, almost high.
Really, Jeff? Oh, you must be exaggerating.
Oh, I wish I were.
Well, thanks for the warning, Leela. But I must go. I'll be late for work.
Meg, I didn't mean to...
I'm sure you didn't. But I'm old enough to choose my own friends now. Goodbye.
Sally, could you tell me when Mrs. Davidson comes in?
Oh, she is in.
Oh, I phoned her office. There was no answer.
You probably just beat her to it. Hang on a second. I'll ring through now.
All right. Morning, Meg. Hey, what's wrong?
Oh, it's nothing. Huh. What are you doing here at this hour?
Another emergency. Lizzie, this time.
Oh, is it serious?
Rather a false alarm, but I think she should be transferred to a cell with other women. She shouldn't be on her own in her condition.
Was that her suggestion?
Yes.
I thought so. I think her problem's not so much a weak heart as a lonely one.
Oh, well, that's what I diagnosed.
Excuse me, Dr. Miller. Mrs. Davidson's in her office now. She'll see you straight away.
Right.
How are the moving plans going?
Well, I've put the practice into the hands of an agent. Now it's just a matter of waiting for a buyer. Still have plenty of time up my sleeve. Be a couple of weeks yet before Karen's out of hospital. Got a hangover, Meg?
No, fit as a fiddle.
Good. You need to be to work in this place.
Jim, can you spare a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Leela phoned me again this morning. She said something about a fight Jeff was involved in Sydney.
Look, Meg, it was nothing, believe me. Leela's led a rather sheltered existence as far as pub brawls go. She found herself in the middle of one. It left a lasting impression on her.
Was that all there was to it? A brawl?
We'd been back from Vietnam for 2 days. There was no picnic over there. Jeff was just letting off steam, that's all. Fights happen when soldiers get a few beers under their belts.
And there was nothing odd about Jeff's behaviour?
No, nothing at all.
I thought it must have been something like that.
Good. Well, we'd better get on duty, eh? Otherwise Vera will have us both on report.
Eleanor, Ros, I'm supposed to be cleaning maternity wing.
All you have to do is say you've got your orders wrong. Look, I just want you to keep a lookout while I check the cells.
It's all right for you. I'm trying to keep my nose clean to get remission.
I've got to find that pen.
And what if you don't?
I will.
Well, you better, because if you don't and you don't tell the screws, I will.
You wouldn't.
You want to try me? I'm not going to stand around and let good screws get knocked off. Besides, it'd be good for my parole.
I'll find it. Just keep guard.
Who's there?
It's only me.
Why aren't you at work?
Well, when you're top dog, you can afford to take some time off. I had things to do.
Where did you get that from?
I've had it in storage for a while. I had to get it out and check it. Because in a month's time, I'll be over in Africa soaking up the sunshine and teaching a mob of blackfellas how to kill one another.
Oh, charming.
And getting paid a mint for it. Just think, eh? If it wasn't for your apron strings, Jimmy could be over there earning 10 times what he's earning now.
I'm a bit particular about how he earns it.
Oh, don't worry, Lee. I'm not going to break up your happy little family circle. Anyway, I should be gone in a couple of days. That should make you happy.
I told you before, any friend of Jim's is welcome to stay as long as he likes. Anyway, what happened to that big deal insurance job you had?
Well, it might be a big deal to some people, but to me, it's just another job. Any beer in the fridge?
Yes.
Good.
Two doing here?
Cleaning, Miss Bennett.
You know there aren't supposed to be two of you on this floor.
Well, maybe I got my orders wrong, Miss Bennett.
I'm sure you have. Go and check the rosters with Mrs. Maguire.
Guess what, Kath? Guess who's moving into your cell?
Who?
Me. The doc and Mrs. Davidson thought I was too crook to be on my own.
You've got it all wrong, Birdsworth.
No, I haven't. The doc said and Mrs. Davidson said I could move.
Yes, you're moving cells all right. You're going in with Smith and O'Connell.
What?
Now get a move on, Leach. I haven't got all day. And I suggest you hurry along too, Coulson.
Wentworth Detention Centre, may I help you?
I'm going out to lunch, Sally. I'll be back in an hour.
Just a moment, Mrs. Fletcher. He's here now.
Your wife.
Yes, Leela, what is it?
It's Jeff. He's brought a gun home and a knife.
What?
It's true. It makes me nervous to be in the house with him.
Well, what do you want me to do about it?
Oh, call the police, Jim.
I can't, Leela. There's no proof.
Oh, God, the same pub, a karate bashing, Jeff's mood last night. What more do you want, a written confession?
I can't waste valuable police time on a case of feminine intuition.
Well, what about the gun?
Well, a lot of ex-soldiers keep guns as souvenirs. But if it makes you happy, I'll talk to him about it when I get home, all right? Now, calm down. I'll see you later.
G'day you, Mr. Fletcher. Don't often see you in this time of day.
No, I thought I'd try one of your counter lunches for a change. The beer, thanks, Baz, and have one yourself. There you go.
Cheers.
Good health. This place is making a bit of a name for itself.
Well, the counter lunches you mean?
No, all the publicity you've been getting lately.
Oh, the bashing. They tell me there were cops all over the place.
Yeah, well, I was in here myself last night. I didn't see anything unusual.
Me neither. It was my night off. I missed all the fun. Real messy was.
Have you heard how he is?
Oh, broken bones, broken nose, collarbone, couple of broken ribs. Bruises that size on his neck. He'd be laid off for a while.
The police any idea who did it?
Nah. And old Brucey's not likely to say anything.
What, you know him, do you?
Struth, yeah. Everybody knows Bruce. He's been coming in here for years to perv on all the blokes. It's pretty harmless, though.
What do you mean he's a horse us off?
As queer as a $3 note, mate.
Ah, room service. Aren't you supposed to knock? And what gourmet pig swill have we got today?
You don't have to eat it. I imagine the food in American jails is a lot better than ours. But then again, you'll find out yourself for certain in a couple of days, won't you?
You should go into politics, Mr. Fletcher. You'd make a good dictator.
Just eat your food.
I suppose I can force it down. As you said, I'll be getting out of here soon.
How come you didn't eat anything?
Why do you think?
Well, I wasn't the only one to notice it.
B knows you're up to something.
I would be. I'm worried sick about that pen.
No, you may as well forget about it because you haven't got enough time to sneak it in the staff room.
The perfect chance. I'm rostered on that floor this afternoon.
That's tough. You haven't got much choice now. Are you going to tell Davidson or shall I?
That's my pen. How did you get it?
I found it. You stole it. Now give it back. Bugger off you. I'm using it.
Oh, what's going on over here?
Give me that pen.
Rack off, Roslyn.
It's her pen, B.
Oh, you would side with her.
I'm not taking sides. I'm just saying it's her pen.
Lizzie?
Oh, I don't know. It could be. I found it on the floor.
Yes, on the floor of my cell. Now give it to me.
You can have it back if it's so special to you. When Lizzie's finished writing her letter.
It's my pen and I want it now.
Oh. All the shouting. Smith? Just a difference of opinion, Mrs. Jackson, but it's all over now.
Lizzie stole my pen, Mrs. Jackson, and I want it back.
Well, that's no excuse for that sort of behaviour. Now, Lizzie, get back the pen.
Oh, but Mrs. Jackson,
why don't we give it back before I decide to report this stupid squabbling? And you two, back to your cleaning. You three can go to the laundry.
Spoiled brat. Oh, come on, Bea. She's not worth wasting your breath over. Mm-hmm.
Right. Now, this section shouldn't take you any longer than 15 minutes. I'll be back to unlock the gate then.
Why don't you just leave it unlocked so I can do the other bit? I can't go very far.
Regulations.
What are you up to, Coulson?
I was just seeing if the urn was full, Mr. Fletcher.
What are you doing in here?
Well, I was told to clean this block.
Yeah, well, you'd better clean the corridor first. It's swimming with soap suds.
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
Hello? What do you want?
I spoke to the barman at the Blaxland at lunchtime today. Apparently the bloke that was beaten up there was well known to him. He was also homosexual.
Well, that's exactly what Jeff said. How would he know if he wasn't involved?
Well, could have been a chance remark.
Oh, you don't believe that or you wouldn't phone me.
I don't know what to believe, Leela. Where is he now?
Oh, he's upstairs. Jim, you've got to phone the police.
I can't. Not on that evidence. Besides, I've known the bloke for years.
Well, does that make him any less guilty?
Look, I'll be home in a couple of hours. I'll have it out with him then, okay?
All right. But you've got to tell the police everything you know. If it was anybody else, you wouldn't hesitate.
I'll see you soon.
I hope so.
I had to sit through an hour and a half of English supper last night. It's enough to make me glad you're on late shift.
That's what you get for marrying a pom.
Coffee? Yes, thanks. The cricket's just as bad. I never get to watch anything I like.
You need two TVs.
Thanks. Oh, it's hot.
Good day, Mr. Fletcher. Coffee?
No, thank you. The bell has gone, you know. Here's the duty officer tonight.
I am, Mr. Fletcher.
Good. Well, come with me and get the duty roster from reception.
He never lets up, does he?
Are you up? Mrs. Manson phoned in sick, so you'll be short-staffed tonight.
What else is new?
Don't forget, keep all connecting security gates firmly locked right throughout the night.
Yes, of course. It's a damn nuisance, though. It takes twice as long to do the rounds where the gate's locked.
Yeah, it can't be helped. It's just an added precaution while that Dominguez woman's here. Won't be for too much longer. Oh, Mrs. Davidson, let me give you a hand. Looks like I've got half your office files here.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher. Yes, I promised myself I'd clear that backlog of work today. I've been here since 7 this morning and I'm still only halfway through.
So you're going to burn the midnight oil tonight, eh?
Yes, I'm determined to get it done. But I'm sick and tired of sitting behind that dreary desk.
Anything you want to watch on telly?
Oh, no, no.
Oh, don't worry about me. If there is, you won't disturb me.
Oh, Jim's home.
G'day, mate. How goes it?
Fine, mate, fine. Jeff, you know what you said this morning about that bashing at the pub?
About what?
About the bloke being queer. How did you know?
You mean he was? Oh, lucky guess, I suppose. Well, if that's the case, he got what he deserved then, didn't he? Oh, come on, mate. You don't think it was me who did it, do you?
I don't know.
Well, that's bloody lovely, isn't it? Known a bloke for years and all of a sudden he's a poof to bash.
Well, he did go to the toilet just before we left.
Oh, for God's sake, that was to answer the call of nature, not some bloody little faggot's invitation.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Jeff, but I don't know. It all seemed to add up. And there was that time in Sydney, after all.
Oh, that was bloody years ago. I mean, what the hell's that got to do with it? God, mate, we've been through a lot together. I dragged you out of the firing line once. I didn't think you'd ever think this about me. It only goes to show, doesn't it? You never really know people. Well, look, mate, I'm going out for a while. I'll be back about midnight. And if you really think it was me who did it, then maybe you just better ring the police.
What are you going to do?
I don't know, love. There's no real proof that it was him. And it's a bit much to try and pin something like that on a bloke just because he happened to lose his temper once 100 years ago.
I believe it, little bitch. Bold as she likes, she dobs Lizzie in front of all of us.
Yeah. And it was only an old pen. Wasn't worth getting into trouble over. I don't know why Ros wanted it back so bad.
It's lucky Mrs. Jackson didn't report you, Lizzie.
Ros is up to something. And I'll lay your odds on it's got something to do with that pen. Anything special about it, Lizzie?
Nah, bloody thing wouldn't even write proper.
noticed how quiet it is tonight? Yeah. And come to think of it, I haven't heard any screws do their rounds yet.
Probably having a party in the staff room.
I bet it's those new rules about keeping the gates locked. They're too lazy to be bothered unlocking them.
You may as well have these, Kath. I won't be needing them.
Yeah, well, I hope for your sake your friends don't leave you behind. Bee's going to be real crook on you for dobbing Lizzie in, not to mention this escape business.
Lizzie didn't get into trouble. Anyway, who cares what Bee thinks? In a couple of hours, I'll be away from her and this dump.
Yeah, leaving me to carry the can. I'll get it from Bee and the screws.
Well, just say you don't know anything.
Oh, sure, and they're going to believe me, aren't they?
I know. I've still got some of that drug left from the capsule that I took. Well, you could take some of that, then you could say I drugged your coffee.
Oh, I don't know. I think I prefer to take my chances.
Don't be stupid. It won't hurt you. You'll just wake up with a bit of a headache, that's all.
Yeah, I suppose it'll get them off my back.
Of course it will. Come on, I'll make the coffee.
Oh, I don't know.
Difficulties. Can I help you?
Yes, I'm having difficulty reaching Wentworth Detention Centre.
What's the trouble?
Well, it's ringing out, but there's no reply, and I know there's someone there.
I'll check it for you. Just a moment, please.
Thank you.
Thank you.
line seems to be working all right. Are you sure there's someone there?
Of course, it's a prison. It's manned 24 hours a day.
Well, in that case, it must be a fault. I'll arrange for a repairman to check it tomorrow.
No. Could you put an emergency call through to the police, please?
Senora Dominguez!
I'm here!
Get as far away from the door as you can.
Take the girl.
Forget about it. Let's get out of here.
No, she'll be useful to us.
We can't risk it.
What risk? She's done her part by dragging the guards. Otherwise, you wouldn't have got this far.
Senor Perez said nothing about taking a girl.
Well, I'm telling you, she's coming with us. I gave her my word. Blow it.
What?
Blow it. You've got more jelly, haven't you? One as well.
We can't. There's no more jelly. We had to blow five to get to you. This place is like Fort Knox.
Keys will be in reception. Come on.
Senor, please. We are at risk.
Don't be ridiculous. They'll be under for hours.
Oh, come on, B. I've got a real good hand here.
Shh, I can hear something.
Probably the screws coming round to find out if we're still alive.
No, they're gone again.
No, they'll be round soon to switch off the lights. They won't forget that.
It's funny. I've never known them be late for lights out before. That's nearly 10:30.
They should have been round 30 minutes ago. I told you. They're having a party in the staff room. Probably all boozed by now.
Yeah, well, something fishy's going on. Hang on, we come back again.
On the chain. Betty, why weren't the lights switched?
Okay, check the stairs and clear. We'll get the girl. What's up? Oh, it's you, Mrs. Davidson.
Have you noticed anything unusual tonight, Tony?
No, it's been as quiet as a grave.
He's been drugged.
I told you, I'll look after you. I will. Now take the drug. Go on, just a spot on your tongue. It's strong stuff.
Quick, what about her?
It's all right.
She's seen me.
We'll be out of the country before she comes to. Now get out of here.
Thanks for everything, Kath.
Come on.
one's been drugged too. Weston Green, check the ground floor. Potter, come with me.
I'll show you the way.
No, you stay here, Mrs. Davidson. Alert the guard on the outer gate and you better call an ambulance.
Shut up and do as you're told. Erica Davidson?
Oh, the ambulance is here, Mrs. Davidson.
Right. I'll open the inner gate for them.
Who put thousands of innocent people behind bars? Don't you see she's the enemy?
Please, we must go.
Kill her!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.